in pursuit of his mandate, sat down and received a proposal from the Inspector General, which proposal was subjected to discussion, and the Commission agreed with the name that was proposed.
The President cannot involve himself in chaffering police officers. If they really wanted to do it right, the National Police Service would have finished with Kaindi, and then the President would be free to pick her as an ambassador anywhere he wishes.
All right, Martha Karua then, Kavuludi, on the issue of dismissal of the DIG. Senator, do you agree this was not handled well, or do you think due process was followed?
First of all, I think it was not handled well. It's good to be honest. And I think, one, if indeed Kaindi's time had come for retirement, mm-hmm. I don't know why they decided again to give her a new contract of saying, you can still stay on, because that is just where the whole mistake again comes in. And that's why I have a big problem with most of our technical people in government, in how we handle things and how we just do a proposal today, tomorrow you wake up and decide, oh, it was wrong, and you just... Now, when the redoing of the whole process starts, you look at it and you wonder, are we really following the law? Because for me, first of all, I don't understand how the police service, the whole police team, can tell me we don't have a woman who is qualified like Kaindi, who can now take over the position. Yet the constitution is very clear, you can only have either gender. Mm. And that is where just I look at it and we say, we cannot accept this, because the moment we accept that proposal now, it means forever they will never respect again either a man or a woman should be in those positions. So I want to ask the police commission, and especially Kavulundi, whatever woman who is there, whether she's now still a corporal but she's qualified, has to move up and get the position. I mean, that is why the constitution, because when they knew Kaindi was going for retirement, in between they would have been looking at who is another senior most mm. woman who we can replace Kaindi with. But you can't just wake up and tell Kenyans, now there are no women. Now we just put in a man. Mm. And anyway, they would have left Parliament to decide that, because they have to still vet either the man or the woman mm. and see how qualified they are.
Yeah.
And for the police, I don't think you really need to look at... Before, we never used to push them to have degrees. So what of this experience are you telling me? You are not looking at the papers. You are looking of the years. So there are women who have been... They are in Kiganjo. They are training this police, they can be recalled and be given.
So then would you agree with those who say that she was being pushed out quickly and in this particular manner because she was interfering with some big type tender money stuff?
No, but where were they? If she was interfering with big tenders, when her time of retirement, they had the best opportunity to just make her move, because her retirement time had come. Why did you give her a new contract then, when you knew already she's an obstacle in your procurement stuff?
Okay. Ah.